Hello guys, it's Panginoon Gaming and welcome back to another Black Desert mobile video. And today we will be talking more about the camp. This will be your in-depth guide for everything you need to know about managing your camp. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Alright, so let's talk about the first structure right about here. So the first structure we will be talking about is the town hall. So the town hall is basically the first structure you will get once you get access to your camp. This is also the structure that you would need to max out first. So it goes from tier 1 up to tier 6. Currently right now the highest tier for the town hall is tier 6. So maxing out your town hall gives you access to more structures, and also this is very crucial in maximizing out everything that you can get from your camp. Simply put, that this is the core of your camp, meaning you can't get any access to other buildings without maxing it out. And also this is where the place where you can expand your camp, because your camp won't start big, pretty much like this camp right here. So this is a tier 6 camp with max expansion, so your camp won't be as big as this. And that's pretty much it for the town hall. The next structure that we will be reviewing is also one of the structures that you will have access once you get your camp. So this is the pub. This is the place where you get your workers. So pretty much like the gear system, also with the accessory system, workers have their own tiers. So we have the white one being the lowest tier. It goes to green, blue, purple, up to yellow workers. And workers have 3 different stats. As you can see right here, workers have vitality, strength, and dexterity. And all of these stats actually have different effects. So the first one is the vitality stat. So vitality is centered around gathering. So this is when you send out your workers to gather materials for foraging, logging, or mining. So the higher the vitality, they will have faster gathering time and also less food consumption. So that's the use of the vitality stat. Now for the strength stat, the higher the strength, the faster your worker can build a structure. So you don't really need a lot of workers with a high strength stat. You just need like at least one worker with a high strength stat. That way, when you need to build new structures, you just need to use that specific worker to reduce the time needed to build that structure. And finally, for the dexterity stat, the higher the dexterity stat, the faster your worker can craft an item. So this stat right here will really help you out, especially for crafting weapon and armor outfits, because those items actually take days, right? So for example, if you use a yellow worker with dexterity as the main stat, it will reduce the time needed to craft the item. So normally it will take around 5 days. With yellow worker with dexterity as the main stat, it will cut it to around 2 days. So that's a huge help for you. And also, high dexterity stat workers are actually used for node managers. This is to increase your chances for a multiplier for the reward. We'll talk more about the node manager later. And that's pretty much it for the stats. Now let's talk more about the currency that we actually use to get workers. And that is the contribution point. So the higher your contribution level is, the more points you have, meaning you will be able to get better workers. And better workers have better stats, so that means faster gathering time, faster crafting time, and also building time. So I really suggest that you work on your contribution points to level it up. All right, so let me show you real quick what a contribution level of 48 can get, like what type of workers. So right now, as you can see right here, I only have purple and yellow workers. The ratio here is I have around 12 to 13 yellow workers and the rest are purple workers. And that is really good, because that's what you need to aim for. The higher your contribution level, the better workers that you will have. And increasing your contribution level is actually not that hard. You can actually increase it by doing main quests and repeatable quests. So basically, the fastest way to increase your contribution level is by creating alternate characters or new characters and finishing the main quests. And you also get a lot of black stones by doing this, so that is a bonus. Phew! And that's pretty much it for the workers and the pub. That was a lot. Moving on to the next structure. Alright, so the next structure that we will be talking about is the refinery. So this is where you actually craft your black stone. Now the black stones that you can craft actually depends on the level of the refinery. The refinery produces stacks of black stones as well, and the tier of the black stones produced depends on the level of refinery. So make sure that you level it up as soon as possible, max it out as soon as possible. So you would need a town hall level 6 to actually reach a level 13 refinery. And the good stuff about having a level 13 refinery is that you get the chance of getting yellow black stones. That's right, yellow black stones. So that will really give you a huge boost. You can also purchase Light Plus to actually help you out with your camp. So purchasing the Light Plus increases the production rate of your black stones from your refinery. And also a lot of good stuff. So as you can see right here, your stamina recovery will be increased by 20%. Also, worker gather rate will be increased by 10%. That's actually a lot, especially if you are gathering with 252 pieces. So that's 25 pieces more. And that is per worker. That's only like the base. If you have like high vitality for your workers, man, you're getting a lot of materials from that. Also, the completion time will be reduced by 20%. So this is good, right? Really, really good, especially if you're crafting armor outfits, weapon outfits, all of the stuff that actually take hours or even days. You also get a horse bond duration increased by 500%. That's actually a really, really long time, and you can get that by just actually calling the horse. You don't even need to ride it. Storage slots will be increased by 10. Stamina consumption gathering will be reduced by 40%, meaning more gathering time, right? This is for your character. When your character is doing some logging, mining, your gather rate or stamina you are using will be reduced to 3 stamina per task instead of 5 per task. This will also increase the resources that you can gather with your character by 20%. So all of this you can get for 14 days. So that is 14 days per plus that you activated. And this is not actually necessary, but if you can get combat pluses or light pluses, this will help you out a lot. You don't even have to spend that much and you'll be able to use it for 14 days. Again, it's not necessary. You can play the game without this. But if you're looking for some help, some boost, then this is like the boost that you can use alongside with the combat plus. Now I just showed you the storage right here. So storage is pretty much straightforward. It's where you can store your items, important items. Also, an important feature is that anything that you store on the storage, your other characters can get it. So this will help you out a lot, especially if you're trying to level up your alt characters. You can actually let them use your equipments like your armor set, your accessory set. That way you can do the main quest way easier, right? That's actually a neat feature that they added. And the next structure right here is the lodging. So the lodging determines how many workers you can get. Every level of the lodging supports one worker. So right now it's level 3, so that's 3 workers per lodging, and I have 10, which is scattered across the camp. So make sure that you level up your town hall as soon as possible so you can get the maximum amount of workers and get more materials, which will help you out a lot in the game. Now the next structure that we will be talking about is really interesting. This is the dye workshop. Now you can build this structure after you defeated boss Oraka in the main quest. So if you're kind of new into the game, that's around level 43 to level 46. Now what makes this structure really important is this is where you can actually craft your armor outfit and weapon outfit, and all of those outfits gives you CP. Also you can craft color palettes which you can use to color those outfits, or you can mix them to get a rare color palette. Now these outfits are really really important because this is another source of CP. The base outfit or the purple ones can give you 10 CP, so that's 10 CP for the armor, 10 CP for the weapon. But we have seasonal outfits. This is actually like the rare outfits you can get in the game, and these outfits have the highest stats. The smallest stats is 16, so that's 16 per stat, right? And the highest stat that you can get is 25 25, so that's from 32 to 50 CP, so that's huge. You can get that on both weapon and armor outfit. You can get the seasonal outfits by fusing the normal outfits or the purple ones, and I suggest that before going for the seasonal outfits, make sure that your camp is at max tier, like tier 6, also that you have the maximum amount of workers as much as possible, because hunting for the seasonal outfits will cost you a lot of resources, lots of materials. So if your camp is not yet max, like your town hall or your structures are not yet max out, it will hinder the progress of your camp. So please max it out first. And the next structure that we will be talking about is the blacksmith. This is where you can craft your gears, that's from blue up to yellow and up to 2 slotted orange equipment. So as you can see here, I can craft weapons from main hand to off hand, pretty much everything, right? From helmet, armor, all of it. That's for yellow tier. Now for orange tier, you can only craft 2 slot items. The materials that you need to actually craft 2 slotted orange gears are actually different, right? You won't be using those stones, you will be using orange gears as well. We have 2 tiers for the 2 slotted gears. The A tier is the Liberto, the Rosar, the Grunil. B tier is like the Yuria, Baris, Aswell, those stuff. Now to craft a B tier, you would need at least 3 one slot orange gears. Now it depends on what equipment you would need. For example, if you need a 2 slotted B tier for main weapon, then you would need at least 3 one slot main weapon. Same goes for the helmet, armor, so on and so forth. Now for you to craft an A tier, you would need 3 B tier equipment. So that goes for weapons, sub-weapons, armors, all of it. Now this is actually a good addition, that way you don't really need to wait for RNG to actually give you an A tier equipment. It's expensive, but hey, at least you have the option to actually craft them. So the next structure is the Expedition Gateway. So this structure is all about ancient ruins, but then again, you don't actually need to click on this structure to get access to ancient ruins, because you can do that anywhere on the map. Now in ancient ruins, you can get a lot of silvers, a lot of experience, also other rewards like orange gears, small chance for orange light stones and crystals, and also alchemy fragments and alchemy stone chests, which contains alchemy stones. We'll get to those alchemy stones later. Now the next one is the rush board. So the rush board, well, it's all about the boss rushes. Again, it's pretty much like ancient ruins, so you can get a lot of XP here, a lot of silver, and also rewards per difficulty you have cleared. The next structure that we will be talking about is the extractor. Now the use for extractor is for disassembling gears and accessories. And for disassembling gears, we have 2 options. So the first option that we have here is the extract stones. So this is used for equipments that have enhancements on them, pretty much like what I will be showing here to you. So I have here a plus 15 lever to staff. So if I use this on the extract stones, pretty much what will happen is I'll be able to get the stones and the ratio is 60%. I can increase the ratio by using Kron stones. And what happens is I can get the stones back, but the item will vanish. The other one is extract gears. For this option, what happens is the enhancement will be removed on the item, but in turn, it will no longer be spirit bound. The item becomes tradable, meaning you can now put it in the market. So you can do this if you have accidentally enhanced something and you want to sell it to market, so you can extract the stones. That way you can put it back in the market. You can extract up to abyssal grade if the extractor is at max level. And there you go, that's pretty much it for the extractor. The next one is the stable. This is where you can manage your horses, like increase their tiers, change their skill. Also, upgrading the stable lets you store more horses and store more feed. And horses have different tiers and different skills, pretty much like pets. But the difference between pets and horses, if you fuse horses or breed them, it will be a guaranteed tier up. And the higher the tier, the faster your horse can run and the more skills they can equip. One of the really cool additions that they actually added, it's a feature for the stable, is now you can store feed. Now what you can do with this is, before, when you are actually trying to level up horses, you need to equip them while grinding, but now you can just equip your highest tier horse, grind on an area, and you can get feed. Now feed is basically XP. You can choose any horses that you have, then just feed until full, so if you do that, they will get to max level right away. So that made fusing, leveling up horses really simple, and I really love this addition. We also have here the ranch. With the ranch, we can raise livestock for food. Now we have two types of livestock. One is sheep and the other one is chicken. Difference between the two is that sheep takes two slots. Right now I have a maximum of 24 slots. If I go for sheep, I can only get 12 sheep at the same time. But if I go for chicken, I can get up to maximum of 24. No worries with that though, because you can get half of them as sheep, then you can get the other half as chicken. So no worries with that. Sheep and chicken also gives you food over time. So chickens will give you eggs every 8 hours, and sheep will give you sheep milk every 24 hours. For a low chance, you can also get golden egg from chickens, which sells 200,000 silvers on NPCs, or golden wool for sheep, which also sells 500,000 silvers on NPCs. Now, if you are a new player, what I would really suggest is that you get chickens instead of sheep. The reason for that is because chickens gives you products every 8 hours, so you have chances of getting golden eggs every 8 hours, so that's 3 times per day. When you compare it to sheep, well, you can only get it once per day, so you only have one chance of getting a golden wool per day. So I would suggest that you get chickens over sheep. Reason why I have sheep is because I'm actually hunting for the golden wool, because this is actually a requirement on collection. Same goes with the golden egg. And that's pretty much it for the ranch. The next one is the trade shop. So the first use for the trade shop is, in every town in the game, there is actually a trader. And the icon for him on every town is coins and then a crate box. So once you got to him, you will see an icon that says deliver, click on that. Now, there are two types for delivering items. The bottom two are the items that you can loot while grinding. Now, the other items that you can see up here are actually items only craftable using the trade shop. So after you delivered all the items, you can hit the update and it will refresh all the items right here. Then you can deliver the next set of items. So that's another option for getting silvers. And as you can see right here, there are actually a lot of items that you can craft. These items are actually needed for collections. So every set of collections requires you different craftable items from the trade shop. And that's pretty much it for the trade shop. The next one we will be talking about is the garden. So the garden is actually the main source of food. So this is where you can plant seeds for food. So different seeds gives you a different time for them to grow and different amounts of food. The best seed that you can actually plant on your camp is the sunflower seed. As you can see here, it only takes 20 hours and it will also give you the highest amount of food from all of the seeds available in the game. But if you're a new player, please don't use sunflower seeds because it will hinder the progress of your camp. Because if you're new, that means your town hall is really low level. That also means that your food limit is really low as well. If you're just starting out, I would suggest that you use seeds that only take 1 hour, like the carrot seeds. You can start using sunflower seeds as soon as your food limit reaches 5,000. Now, where to purchase sunflower seeds? All you need to do is go to North Calpheon, then go to Northern Plantation and look for Norma. And there you go, this is where you can buy or purchase the sunflower seeds. And if you notice, I actually have discounts with Norma, right? I actually got discounts because I did the Amity quest for her. So as you can see here, the Amity already reached 92 points. Now with Amity, different NPCs gives you different rewards. So what I did here is actually went for NPCs that gives Black Pearls as rewards. Also doing Amity quests will give you different effects. Like with Norma, she gave me discounts. Doing Amity quests also gives you a lot of contribution XP. So if you really need that contribution level to go up, doing Amity quests is also one of the best ways where you can get XP. You can normally see the quest tab right next to the interest tab when you're doing your Amity. So don't forget to do that. As per task that you complete, it's 300 XP points. So that's really a lot of XP points, and the quest that the NPC actually gives you is really simple. You just need to talk to another NPC. That's it. And you get 300 XP points for contribution level. So don't forget to do those if you haven't already. We also have food storage right here. So this is pretty much self-explanatory. This is pretty much like a refinery, but you don't have to collect them. So over time, this will produce food. And leveling up the structure also increases the maximum capacity of food that you can store. And the next structure that we are looking at is the trading post. The trading posts actually have two functions. The first one is by exchanging resources. What I mean by exchanging resources is pretty much like what I'm doing right now. I'm actually exchanging iron ores to copper ores. And you can do this with all of your other resources. And the next function that you can do with the trading post is the node manager. And with the node manager, this is actually where you can get a lot of stuff, like mainly silvers, boss rush tickets, tablets for ancient ruins, and black stones, and all of other good stuffs that you can see right here. You can also get special nodes from time to time, which gives you a lot of black stones, boss rush tickets, a lot of tablets, and black pearls, so watch out for those. Now for putting workers in your node manager, I would suggest that you use workers with a really high dexterity stat, as high dex workers will give you a higher chance for a multiplier. Now, what do I mean by a multiplier? It literally means multiplying the resources you will get from the node manager. Multiplying it to 2 up to 3 times, that's actually a lot and really helpful. So make sure that you use a high dexterity worker on your node manager. Using the node manager also increases the node manager level. So the higher the level of your node manager, the higher the number of workers that you can use, and also it increases the nodes that you can obtain. And as we all know, the further the node is, the better the rewards. And that's pretty much it for the node manager. Let's move on to the next one. And the next structure that we will be talking about is the monument. So we have a total of 3 different monuments in the game, which actually gives you 3 different effects. So as we can see right here, the monument I'm using right now is the Monument of Battle. So this will give you 10% increase in combat XP for 2 hours. So you can only use this once every day. Another note here is you can only use 1 monument at a time, meaning if you want to use a different monument, you would need to collect the other monument. So let's talk more about the different effects that you can get per monument. For the Monument of Vitality, you will get 50 stamina per day. For the Monument of Battle, we already talked about this, you will get 10% XP boost for 2 hours, so that's per day. Now for the Artisan's Monument, it will be an XP boost for the life skills. Life skills like fishing, mining, logging, all of those gathering stuff. And the next structure that we will be talking about is the Relic Altar. So the Relic Altar is the place where we actually feed our relics, the relics that we no longer need. This pretty much works like the Black Spirit where you feed your stuff, but the difference is that you can feed the relics and increase different stats. So we have the Easy Burden, which increases the storage, the Wisdom of Battle, which increases the combat XP that you get, and the Goblin's Blessing, which increases the drop rate. And that's actually pretty much it for the Relic Altar. If you ask me which one you would need to prioritize, or you would want to prioritize, I would suggest Wisdom of Battle over Goblin's Blessing, because right now we are looking forward to the tower update where we will be using a lot of alternate characters, so leveling them up to 60 is actually really, really important. So the higher XP boost, the better. Next structure we will be looking at is the Deco Shop. So for the Deco Shop, well, it's pretty much straightforward. It's where you can actually build decoration for your camp. Other uses for the Deco Shop is items that are actually craftable on the decoration shop are also needed for collection. So it's pretty much like the trade shop. And for the last and final structure that we will be talking about is the Alchemy Lab. In the Alchemy Lab, you can actually do a lot of stuff. One of them is to craft potions, the large potions that you can see right here. So this large HP potion is actually not purchasable from any NPC in the game. And this potion can really help you out when it comes to important contents in the game, like the Siege Wars, Node Wars, or Guild Wars. You can also craft crystal chests here in the Alchemy Lab. So right now the highest crystal chest that you can craft is the Supreme Crystal Chest, which gives you a chance of getting a unique crystal, which again you can fuse in turn to get a chance of getting a yellow grade crystal. Other stuff that you can craft right here are also Crown Stones and Lightstone Fragments. It's also where the castle holders can craft their mystical grade accessories, or the orange accessories. So as you can see right here, to craft regal accessories you would need golden fragments, which is only available for siege castle holders. Now let's talk more about the newly added feature in the Alchemy Lab, which is the Alchemy Stones. So Alchemy Stones is another source for CP increase. Only that, there are special stones that actually gives you a different set of effect, like increased damage to world bosses, or increasing the power of the Watcha, the cannons for Siege Wars and Node Wars, a lot of stuff really. This is where we can craft the alchemy stone fragments into alchemy stones, and you can get those fragments by doing the ancient ruins. This is also where we can fuse the stones that we no longer need for a chance to get a higher rarity stone. We also have the option to amplify the stones. Amplify is pretty much similar to the enhancement for gears like main weapons, armors, and accessories. So increasing the enhancement increases the effects of the stones, and it's different from stone to another stone because other stones have special effects. And with those type of stones, the effects are only increased every 10 levels. And that's pretty much it for the Alchemy Lab. Oh, right, another cool feature they actually added onto the game is the Camp Manager. So getting a Camp Manager really helps you out in managing your camp. They will automatically collect camp funds, manage the ranch, auto-collect items from the refinery. They will also auto-plant, harvest plants in your garden, move items from your inventory to storage. Now that's actually neat, and they will also feed your horses automatically. So if you want some auto managing stuff happening on your camp, go get a camp manager. So all of these camp managers have the same effect. The only difference is the avatar. So you can get Butler Alfred, or they call it Raymond here. You can get the waifu Irene, or you can get the other guy. The other guy is probably for the girls. And that's pretty much it for the camp manager. And whoo, there we go, that finishes the tutorial for the camp. Do you have any other questions about the camp? Let me know down in the comments below. Also, if you are watching this and you haven't played Black Desert yet, and you're thinking, hey, this game looks cool, I wanna give it a try. Hey, I got some good news for you. You can download the game with the link down below, and you can also use my code right here. For new players using my code, you can get Camp Plus, Combat Plus, and Black Spirit Plus. And there you go, that's pretty much it for today's video. Once again, thank you so much guys for watching the video. Please don't forget to hit the like button, smash the subscribe button, and don't forget the notification bell, so you can get notified once I upload my next video. This has been Panginoon Gaming, and I'll see you on the next one.